welcome to the Fit Rush. And today, I'm at Jarakabande Forest. It's very special to me because I ended up doing my first ultra marathon here. So I'll tell you a little bit about this place. Like I told you about Jarakabande, the best part about this is it's an actual forest and it's a eucalyptus forest. So every time you run, you get the natural smell of the eucalyptus. So not only it's a visual treat for your eyes, it is also really good for your body and for your pulmonary tract, because you're getting in the smell of all the eucalyptus. It's really good. It's a very beautiful place again. Now, why Jarakabande is very special to me? I did my first ultra marathon here, and that was hosted by Basin Sports. And my first run was a 50 kilometer run. This loop is about 6 to 7 kilometers, one loop inside the forest. So I had to do 50 kilometers of that. This company called Dreams, they have come out with a new initiative where they are conducting these virtual runs, and because of this lockdown situation, we are actually not able to go out and work out, and we don't have that much of motivation to drive us to in order to help us reach our goals. So Dreams has come out with a virtual run where they have runs starting from 2 kilometers all the way to 42 kilometers, which is happening on the 19th of July. Yes, the 19th of July. I will also be participating in it. It's just a one-day event where you have to go ahead and register. I'll be putting the link in the description below. Go ahead and register and you will be able to run. It's a 24-hour event, so you can run, walk and complete the challenge even if you want to do 42 kilometers. So for that, you will also be receiving a medal, an e-certificate based on the category that you're registering. So do check out the link below, and I hope to see you guys in the virtual run. Okay, so we are at Jarakabande, as you already know. It's a eucalyptus forest. Now, why this place? I didn't actually get a chance to explain to you guys why this place is super special to me. Because this forest, or this experience that I had in this forest, completely changed me. So it made me from being a normal road runner into an ultra runner. Yes, this was the first place that I ended up doing my first 50 kilometer run, thanks to Basin Sports and Basin Sir. So he conducted the run he conducts runs here every year. So I ended up participating. And this was a time that I had not even completed my full marathon. So Basin sir ended up giving me an opportunity to try the ultra marathon. So I ended up doing the ultra marathon and I completed it. So now during the run, what had happened was, this place has a lot of elevation and it is slightly difficult to run, but it is beautiful. It's so beautiful for the soul. So I started off my run and in the 12 kilometer mark, I was down with IT band. So my IT band was completely ruptured and I was not able to walk. I had a huge swelling on my knee and I thought it's over. And this was my first ultra marathon. So, you know, every first run has a lot of feeling for every person. Every first event has a lot of feeling for a person. So I was very disappointed that I thought I might not be able to complete it. But I went to the doc. I mean, there was a doctor at the site and he gave me some painkillers and put a brace on my leg. I ended up actually walking, jogging the entire 38 kilometers. And I completed my 50 kilometer run with an IT band problem. So it's all about that determination and willpower of how badly you want to achieve your goal. So that's something that I really wanted to talk about today. And so I ended up completing my 50 kilometer run here. And the following year, I ended up registering for a 100 kilometer run and I ended up completing the 100 kilometer here at Jarakabande. So if any of you guys are out there who are thinking that no, I can't do it because of this problem or because of some other problem, I just want to tell you guys, just dig deep and, you know, just complete it. Just dig deep inside yourself and just complete it, because your mind may give up first, but your body will never give up. But at the same time, I would also want to say, don't do something that is extremely reckless, because you have to understand the border between risk and recklessness. So that's something really important. Always listen to your body and yeah, go about doing your challenges. So right now I'm here and I must complete my run. So I'll just show you a small look or a viewpoint of what I am seeing. So we're pretty much done with the run, just walking around in the trail of Jarakabande, and it's absolutely beautiful. More than anything else, why I like running in trail, it's just so satisfying to the soul. There's no traffic, there is no disturbance, no pollution. It's just you and the wilderness. It's just you and absolutely the wilderness. And I'm really enjoying the small trek back. Another thing about running in Jarakabande that you need to be aware of, the trail is actually loose rocks. So the chances of you falling is very, very high. So if you guys are coming here and running, make sure that you're very, very cautious and very, very safe while you're running. And when you're coming and running over here, there's absolutely nothing outside for food or anything. So just get your own refreshments and food while you're coming here. So it can also work out as a very nice picnic spot, because it's a very beautiful place. Do come and check out Jarakabande. I highly recommend runners out there to come to Jarakabande and run a couple of loops in here. It's definitely challenging, and the location will also be down in the description. I'll tell you where exactly this is. It's called Jarakabande Kaval. It's in Yelahanka. So from here, I'm not able to get it in my camera, but somewhere there is Nandi Hills. So you can actually see Nandi Hills all the way from here, and you can also spot Samandurga from somewhere there towards that side. So I'm trying to spot some peacocks over here. There are some peacocks. I did see some peacocks over here, but I'm not able to get it in the camera because they are very cautious about us moving around over here. Let me see if I can probably get a shot of a peacock, but I have to get really, really close without it noticing. Let's see. Some parts of the woods over here, we heard some peacocks and we did spot there. Well, I tried getting a shot of the peacock. I did see a couple of peacocks once or twice, but it's just impossible to get them because they move so swiftly and you know, you can't actually spot them, and you know, they can hear every single movement of yours. And yeah, probably next time when I come and I get a DSLR, I can probably shoot some photos and show you guys. But there are a lot of peacocks over here. You can actually hear all of them in the morning. And when we started our run, we were able to hear them. I'm coming to the end of the vlog, so make sure to subscribe, hit the like button, and hit the notification bell. Do support me on the channel, and I'll see you again with another video. Stay safe, stay fit. So you saw how beautiful this place is, and I read in the newspaper that some part of this forest is going to be converted into a highway, and it's really sad that they're going to chop out so much acres of forest just to construct a roadway. I wish something could be done about this and something could be prevented, because this is actually very beautiful. And it's also a proper living environment for all the peacocks and all the other animals that are out here. And by getting a highway road through this place, it's just going to destroy the beauty of this place. And we are just doing what we have always been doing, destroying the earth. And I wish something could be done about this. But I did read it in the newspaper that they are going to chop out some part of this forest in order to make the road. So I just thought I'll let you guys know about this too. Peace out.